Welcome to Small Arm Solutions. Today we're doing a product video on one of my favorite products in the industry, and not to mention it's something that I use damn near every day because I do a lot of shooting and I have arthritis and it can be very challenging sometimes to load magazines. And the product that we're looking at today are the Maglula series of products, which refer to mostly as the UpLula, which is load and unload tools. We have a bench loader, and we're going to show you all the different products that they have. Again, you've heard me talk about it in videos in the past. You know, I have arthritis issues, and I shoot a lot of rounds. And if I had to load magazines by hand, it would be a brutal experience, and I wouldn't get much shooting done. The Maglula products have helped me for many, many, many years, being able to load magazines painlessly and unload them painlessly. It just makes it a very, very simple process. Now, a lot of you will say, well, I don't need tools. I can do it by myself, no problem. Well, you know what? Doing, you know, two or three magazines, four magazines, it's not really a big deal. Well, when you're loading up 10, 15 magazines like I do every day, when we go out to do the range testing, it makes all the difference in the world having a proper loading tool. Maglula has offered solutions for the most popular firearms in the world. I want to give you a little bit of a background on the company as well. The company was invented by a guy named Ron Tall. Now, Ron Tall was an IDF guy. He was in the Seven-Day War, and he had had issues with his Uzi getting sand in it and causing problems with the magazines with the sand and loading and unloading and so forth, and he knew there had to be a better way. So he came up with the Lula, the load and unload device, which you see right here, for an Uzi. And this helped him load and unload magazines. It made it easy to load magazines because loading these stick magazines, the straight magazines, can be a very brutal experience. Many of you guys who use the Colt 9mm submachine guns and Uzis know that when you're loading those magazines, it's extremely difficult once you start getting down to the last 10 or 15 rounds. And I can premise this by saying I was in India for Colt. We were doing a demonstration for the Octopus and Greyhound, which is their special forces. They were doing a competition between the Colt 9mm submachine gun and the MP5. And you had a whole bunch of these commandos who were loading magazines for our test, and they were complaining about loading our magazines because they didn't, you know, HK was there the week before, and they didn't have that problem that they did with ours. And fortunately, I happened to have a couple of these in my backpack, and I gave them to them. Well, Colt, we ended up winning that contract for that, and it ended up requiring that a Maglula would come with every single SMG that we sold them to make it easier to load the magazines. So now we're going to go forward to his son, Guy. Now, Guy was IDF also, but he carried an M16. So he developed one for his son to load and unload the M16 magazines. And it snowballed from there. This is a company that's based outside of Tel Aviv. They're made all made in Israel. And I think we're just going to jump right into it. We're going to start showing how these suckers work. And the one I'm going to start with is the one that I use more than anything because of pistols. Now, pistol magazines can be very painful to load because sometimes you have sharp feed lips when you're trying to go through like that and trying to push down. It can be very, very difficult. So this is referred to as the UpLula. Now, what's really cool about the UpLula is this will take any 9.40, 45 caliber magazine that's out there, and it will load them. It has an adjustment in the back that adjusts to the side, and it will also take single column. So I think what we're going to do first is we're going to show you how these work. This is a standard Beretta M9 magazine. So what we're going to do is we just drop it over the top, and we pull in, push down, and you have a ramp that drops the round in. Now you release, go back up. Drop the round in, release, go back up. Drop it and go back up. Now this will load. And again, any 9mm 40, 45 caliber magazine, it will load. Now comes a situation where we want to unload. We have a little tab on here that we go right over the top. And it unloads. So now, you 1911 guys, so now we have the single column 45 magazine. There's another adapter that you can buy, which just snaps right over. Now, you take your 45 magazine, you drop your 45 magazine in, take your 45 rounds, exact same. And there's your five rounds. Now, this will also work with single column 9mm magazines as well. Very few magazines I've ever found that don't work in this. Now, we're going to have a master list of all these products that shows you where you can buy them on our website, smallarmsolutions.com. And again, to unload, that's all there is to it. This tool is invaluable. I use this, like I said, every time I go to the range, this loads up all my magazines. And they also have magazines, loaders for 22s, single column 22s. I don't have any of those because I don't shoot 22s. That's probably the one part of the product line that I don't have. But the Uplula is undoubtedly the most valuable of all the products, and everybody should have one of these in their range bag. This makes your life so much easier. So now we're going to go right to the M16 magazines. We have what's referred to as the Uplula for the M16. What we do is we have a lever. Now that lever will push down and we drop the round in. Push down, drop the round in. And we continue doing that for 30 rounds. So now comes time to unload the magazines. All we do is we put this back on and it unloads the rounds. This one here has been adopted by many militaries. In fact, I have one of these that's really cool. It has a writing from the IDF on it. This is extremely useful. Now, you guys say, well, I can do them just as fast by hand. Yeah, you can. 3, 4, 5 magazines. Start trying to do this with 10, 12, 20 magazines. This makes it much, much easier. Now, for military guys who get issued ammunition and stripper clips, there's also a tool called the Striplula, which all we do is it drops on the back of the magazine. As you see, we take your stripper clip, drop it in the top, lift over, and push down. And we can do that for our 30 rounds, so we can take them all off. So then all we do is we tip it, drop the stripper clip out, drop in our next 2 and 3, and there you have it. So the Striplula will work excellent. I've used both the aluminum stripper clips that we have here in the U.S. and also the Canadians that use a polymer stripper clip that's basically the same size. It works with those two. And I think I've also tried some from Gecko that worked in this as well. Now we have one more option for 5.56. This is referred to as the bench loader. Now again, do you need this to do 1 or 2 magazines? No. But you're looking at doing multiple magazines, yes. The way this is designed, this will take any AR-15 M16 type magazine in the industry. I have tested everything I've got on this and it's worked perfectly. All you do is you drop in the magazine. We take our rounds. So now we have all 30 rounds in there. Of course, we can do 20s, we can do 30s, doesn't matter what the magazine is. Then all we do is we there you have it. Now, again, I keep saying this over and over again. Do you need this for 1 or 2 magazines? No. But when you're looking at doing 20 or 30 magazines, this thing works excellent. This also could be screwed down to a bench to make it a little bit easier as well. So now we're going to look at the AK-47. Now, this will also work on the Galil 5.56 magazines. But we drop it in like so, and it works the exact same way the other ones do. That's all there is to it. Now, one of the newest products that they have, this is meant for the American market, is an Uplula for the 7.62x39. Now, the regular M16 one will not work for this one just due to the fact that the cartridge just sits so high, the way the cam is on here, it doesn't fit. So we do this the exact same way. We drop down, drop your rounds in place. There you have it. Now, with the popularity of the 7.62x39 ARs, this is a really cool tool. Again, this is brand new. I've actually been doing some recent videos with 7.62x39 AR magazines, and I've used this one quite a bit. SR25-308 magazines. This has worked on every magazine that I have had so far. I've had no issues at all, and it works the exact same way with a 7.62. Drop down. There you have it. It just pops right off. Next one we're going to look at is M14. M14, it's a little bit more difficult with that because of the way it fits on. Now, when an M14 magazine fits into the rifle, you have a notch here, and then you have your latch goes on the back right here. So what we do is we have the front notch goes in place. Then when we drop that down, we have this gate, which goes on the bottom of the magazine. And then we load and unload the exact same way. Same thing. There's a couple other magazines, loaders, that are based off of the M14. As you'll see, we have here, this is the AR-10 Armalite. Now, this one's a little bit more difficult because of the way that Armalite, the magazines have the tab that comes out that engages the bolt catch. Now, because of the way this is, before you can start using the Lula, you have to drop your first couple rounds in. You have to push inward on that tab so it clears. Then once that clears, we take the Lula, engages, then we go ahead and we can load the magazines. So this is for the AR-10 Armalite. Next two are very, very similar, but a little bit different. We have the FAL. Now this one here is very similar to the M14 because of the way that it engages. You have your front notch, and then you have your locking notch in the back. So that's how that one will engage for the FNFAL. Next one is for the SCAR. Now the SCAR basically it's a FAL magazine. That's basically what it is, but the only difference is the way that it engages. Instead of having the front notch on there, it has a very similar notch compared to that of the AR-10 M16 type. That just drops right on the top like so. Next one is the G3. G3 works very, very similar. It has a notch on the side. Just drop it right on the top. And there you have it for the G3. Now we have four submachine guns. Now the only one that I'm missing here is MP5. I don't own an MP5, so I never really bothered getting my hands on one. But we have this one here for the MPX. Works very, very similar to everything else. It just drops right on the top. Drop your 9mm round in place. There you have it. This is also relatively new. This is the CZ Scorpion. Works the exact same way. Just drop down, drop your round in place. And now we have, this is for the Colt. Now there's two. You have both one for the Colt and one for the Uzi. The difference obviously with the Colt is you have the magazine release here. The Uzi is a little bit different, but it's very, very similar. But this is the Colt pattern. Anybody who owns a Colt, a pattern SMG or carbine, this is absolutely a must. These two magazines are fairly easy to load, even up to 30 rounds, because of the way they are. The Uzi Colt magazines, on the other hand, no. They can become very difficult when you start getting those last 10 or so in there. So I definitely would recommend anybody who has a Colt pattern type rifle or an Uzi get one of these. So they basically have covered most everything. I do believe they have one for the Mini 14, which obviously I don't have because I'm not a Mini 14 fan. For as far as the bench loaders, they also have them for G3 magazines. I imagine you'll probably be seeing a 5.45 at some point. Again, it's not as popular. But he's continued to come out with new ones every year. A couple years ago, he came out with one for the Ruger 10/22. I've been meaning to pick one of those up, but again, I just don't shoot 22s. But these are ones I use on a regular basis. And these are tools that I use weekly. Every time I go to the range, I have an Uplula in my range bag, and I have a M16 magazine Uplula in my range bag also. Those stay there. Most of my magazines I load at home, so they're preloaded when I go out, so I don't have to do it. I usually do it the day before, because again, because of my arthritis, I do everything the day before. I use all these tools here. You know, it's magazines, when you're doing a few of them, you know, it's not an issue. There's certainly no question. But anybody who's doing quantities, yes. Pistols, especially if you have magazines that have sharp feed lips, These work on everything. I mean, you know, except, you know, Glock, Beretta, SIG, HK. I've used them on everything. 9mm, 40, 45. 10mm, no. 10mm is longer. So that's the one that they won't work with it. They do have some of the smaller ones as well for some of the smaller caliber pistols. I don't have because I don't use them. The ones that you see here are ones that I use on a fairly regular basis. So I hope you guys do enjoy this video. Please click like, please subscribe, even better, share. Thank you.